Blessed day to everyone. I will be reading to you our text for today from Philippians chapter 3 verses 13 to 14. Brothers and sisters, I do not consider myself yet to have taken hold of it, but one thing I do, forgetting what is behind and straining toward what is ahead. I press on toward the goal to win the prize for which God has called me heavenward in Christ. What life goals do I have now? How do they involve building up God's kingdom? A new school year has started and another has ended. We are now in the present and we can now have something to call a past. I assume that you have set a goal for yourselves this school year that may motivate you to pursue excellence and get nearer to that dream you have for a long time. Maybe you dream of graduating with Latin honors. Or maybe you settle on just improving your grades from the previous semester. Some of you may have modest goal of just finishing the semester without a failing grade below average. Whatever it may be, how do they involve building up God's kingdom? In one of the Gospels, Jesus said, "What does it matter for a person to gain the whole world and lose his life?" And that is why here at Central, you are not only taught to excel academically, but also to gain exemplary Christian education for life. Our lives will not be defined by our profession, but how it's lived for the glory and honor of our God. Anything else comes in second. If you haven't given any thought yet on how your goals be involved in building up God's kingdom, here is one way we can slowly introduce it to our daily lives. According to our scripture text, what Paul did in order to make a move forward is he forgets what is behind. Yes, whatever achievements or failures he had last school year, last semester, they are all in the past. It can have a bearing on your Latin honors, but it's not the end and not the defining moment of your life. You may feel its impact on the future, but don't dwell on it. Whether you were victorious or a loser in the past, you can draw lessons from them and make it as a tool toward achieving your ultimate goal. Confess your shortcomings if you failed and be grateful for your accomplishments. It was God's grace that you made it this far. Let your goal be set on a prize for which God has called you in Christ Jesus. Move forward. There is much more to do from this day forth. Let us pray. In this world full of things that we desire, O God, you are the source of every good and perfect gift. May we not lose sight of this truth that our success is a gift from you. Help us to set goals that are worthy of your approval. Make our hearts focused on the good and perfect gift you only can give, instead of on what the world presents us with. Open our hearts to the truth of your word, so that we will have an anchor where we can hold on to as we go along our journey. For in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we pray all these. Amen.